Okay, so really quick, Koolatron thermoelectric wine coolers. They come in various sizes and capacities. This guy here is a 12 bottle. They come in like 4 bottle all the way up to, I don't know, like 26 or something. The much larger ones use a traditional compressor and refrigerant. These much smaller guys use a Peltier type cooler with fans for dissipation of the heat and the temperature on the inside. It is the same premise behind those portable automotive and camping coolers that you plug into a cigarette lighter and it kind of chills the inside of the cooler. The problem with these, and I've seen this on at least 3 of these units now, this is the second that I've applied this fix to, is the power supply slash control circuit. This is not it, because I've already yanked it out and threw it in the garbage. I don't know what the problem is or what the component is that fails on there. It's not something easily visible, like a swollen electrolytic or a transistor that's shat itself, or a thermistor or anything like that. Some brief research online also shows that other people are trying to fix this as well and can't really figure out what affects that power supply or the control circuitry in the power supply. So I don't know. Cheapest and easiest way I found to salvage this thing is to just get your own power supply and your own little thermostat and modify it as such. So this is a 12 volt 10 amp power supply. You do have a little like an adjustment here, a trimming pot that you can increase or decrease the voltage within a few degrees so that you can compensate for, losses and whatnot. And I just have it maxed out at 14 volts and it's working quite nice. Now, if I were to just simply connect the power supply to the Peltier and the fans, this thing would be running 24/7. So you want to be able to, of course, set your temperature. Now, the original one, or rather the original temperature setting was in here. It was just a little knob, same sort of rheostat deal, had a little single blue LED. And it interfaced with that all-in-one power supply. So I yanked that out, and actually up here is where my temperature probe is for my thermostat. I don't know if you can see it. All I did was hot glue it, ran the wire in the back, drilled a hole, passed it through, and that was the end of it. I mounted the controller up here, found the center point, measured it, cut it out with a Dremel. Oops, there go my screws. Popped it in. Between the cost of the 12 volt 10 amp power supply and this, it was I don't know, like $10 or $15 US from China shipped. The controller like this, if you hop on the flea bay or AliExpress or what have you, even probably Amazon, you can find the same one for a couple dollars. You can do heating and cooling, so it's just changing the relay to normal open or normal close. You can set the threshold, which is, within a difference of how many degrees it's going to engage, and you have temperature compensation and some other features. It's a little bit weird with the menu system how it works, but once you figure it out, it does work quite nicely. So the coldest I can get it, depending on the ambient temperature, is probably about 9 or 10 degrees centigrade. And the inside chills quite nicely. So it is only intended to be a wine cooler after all. It's not really a large refrigeration device. But if you're having the same problem with yours, which is that it's not cooling, this is one fix around it. If you do have any information as to what the problem is that fails on the original power supply and control circuit, please do leave a comment. I would be very interested to know.